Data Science and Data Engineering Meetup of 2019. And thank you very much, Maktim, for hosting the meetup, for providing the good pizza. And Sia will be starting off today with providing some statistics of the previous year of our meetup.
Thank you everyone for coming. I know it's a bitterly cold day, and that makes it even more impressive that you guys mustered the energy to actually come out and rather than going home after a long day at work. I hope you have an amazing time over here. We thought it would be a good idea to discuss a little bit about how 2018 was for this meetup group, what we actually did, and where we started off from. So just 5 minutes of what we actually did last year. So this meetup group actually was formed in November of 2015, so quite a few years ago. It was originally called the Waterloo Data Science, a simple short name. But between 2015 when it started and 2017, there were only about 4 meetup events. One in November of 2015, and then 2 or 3 in 2016, and then one, I think, in 2017. So it wasn't, in fact, April 2016. So in a 6-month period, we had 4 meetups, and then nothing since then. So it was more or less a dead group. There was nothing much happening over here. So Mary Lovell took over as the organizer of this meetup group in November 2007. Did I say November 2007? It should be November 2017, yeah?
2017, yes.
And a month later, I joined as a co-organizer of this meetup group. So we deliberated, we decided how we should actually reboot this, what the kind of focus it should actually have. We rebranded it as the Waterloo Data Science and Data Engineering because the focus was a little more encompassing. We just didn't want to focus on the data scientists. We wanted to give due attention to the data engineering portion of this entire space as well. After the reboot, the first meetup was held in January 2018, so almost exactly a year ago. Since then, this has been how things have moved along. So this is when we took over. There were about 420 members. As you can see, not much participation. There was more or less a dead group. And then since then, they've just shot up and gone from strength to strength. As of today, we have 928 members. Almost getting to the 1,000 mark, so please advertise on our behalf. Let's get to that 1,000 member mark in the next month or so. You can see member participation has increased. It's been fairly nice to have that happening. These are the meetup events that we had last year. So in January, February, March, we had a series of sessions on recommendation system where we deliberated and discussed and so how different recommendation systems were built. In April, we had a meetup group on how to productize analytical models. So these recommendation systems that were analytical models that were developed, we wanted to show that these are standalone experimental models, but if you want to productize them, then how do you actually do so? In July, we had a session on talking about cloud-based databases as well as data stores. In fact, that meetup was held right here in this very space. In August, we had individuals from the industry come in and participate, and they talked about knowledge graphs and how to ace data science interviews that was given by Lovell and Arthur Khan. And then in October, we talked about text mining, and we had a panel discussion as well. Text mining was presented by an individual from the University of Waterloo as part of the ongoing research that they were doing, Arthur Khan. And the panel discussion, we had a number of individuals from the industry, and we had a panel discussion similar to the format that we have today later today. And then in November, we had a session on text embeddings by Armand Didande, he's right there, and data security, data science, that's something that I have presented. So the idea was that we know what data security is, we know what data science is, but you know, what about the nexus of the two, or the overlap of the two, or how do we actually manage data security and data science? The locations that we've been haunting. So we had a few sessions at the terminal facility, the old terminal, the original terminal facility, and then a new one. And Communitech has been very generous. So we've had a session at Communitech, we had a session at Communitech Data Hub. We had one in Shopify, and this is where we have all that. mapped in by the top of the map. So we've been all over. Participation by numbers at the meetup events. So these are the RSVPs. We try not to have too many RSVPs because we don't want the space to be overwhelmed. We don't want it to be too crowded. So you see this gradual uptake of different individuals coming in or RSVPing. We don't do registration at the front desk, but we have numbers that we track on the meetup group. And you can see numbers have constantly climbed higher and higher over the year. The individuals subscribing or joining our meetup group. Initially, there was a large number of people joining in, and then things just started falling flat once they won more meetups, so there was no activity of the group. We took over here. We started advertising our meetups at this point in time, 2018, and you can see the number of individuals joining every week. It's very rare to see a week where there are actually less than 25 or less than 30 people joining in. And in some weeks, you could see these huge numbers of members joining our group. Like over here, you have 75, more than 75 people. This is around the time that we had that event at Shopify. So a great number of people joined. So each event is followed up by a great number of people joining, or maybe a few days before, because when they are RSVP, they also become a member of the meetup group as well. So you have lots of individuals joining every week. Social networks, we advertise our meetup events. Initially, before the meetup is to be held, we advertise it on social media, and then obviously once the meetup is held successfully, we post some pictures, we share status, we say thanks to the sponsors and the speakers and the people who came on and participated, our volunteers as well. This is just an example of the last one that I had. You can see generally in the number of likes and the number of views. So we get about 75 likes, 7,000 plus views. This was around 4,000, but in the previous one, we've had 7,000, 8,000 views of my post on the meetup group as well. So pretty substantial attention is being gathered, and I'm not showing stats from LinkedIn, but you'd find more than 1,000 views, for example, in the Kitchen Walk Note feature, maybe more than 1,000 to 1,500 views from the Greater Toronto Area, around 2,000. Some of it is from the Silicon Valley. A few hundred people, a few hundred views would actually come from the Silicon Valley. So fairly widespread attention is actually being given to the post for the Kitchener Waterloo Data Science Data Engineering Meetup. Finally, this could not have been done without the active contribution of our sponsors, whether it's in the form of letting us space, like this space that we have on mapped in, or in the form of individuals coming on board and presenting. So we've had individuals from several of these companies coming and presenting as on behalf of their organization. And finally, the form of food and drink. So thank you to our sponsors. We really appreciate it. We could not have done this without them. So what do we have planned for 2019? Quite a few things. And you know, as the year progresses, we'll be refining these ideas a little bit more. But the idea is to give exposure to individuals who need an audience where they can actually come up and present their work. For example, Abhil Khan, she came from the University of Waterloo to present some of the research that they were doing over there. So that was very well received by the audience. So this is a channel through which people can actually can reach out to an audience and present the work that they are doing, the exciting work that they are doing. We want to offer this complementarity of meetups. So we have quite a few meetup groups in the Kitchener-Waterloo region that focus on data or data science or artificial intelligence. We want to offer, we want to supplement them, we want to offer a complementarity of focus rather than overlapping with them. So that's an aspiration that we have. We want to foster this ecosystem, so just like everyone is coming over here, we want to put this as a forum where people can actually come, exchange ideas, particularly the panel discussion that you see immediately after. This is just an opportunity for letting people come into this space and to understand what the challenges are. And for people who are experienced, like Atif and Arman, who will be coming here in a little while, they can actually share and help guide those individuals as well. So we want to connect people from both sides. And finally, we also want to have a hands-on demonstration of different technologies, different algorithms, different techniques which are widespread, and just to get a greater audience familiar with them. Anyway, so that's it. Thank you.